Do emotions make people fall for misinformation? While the World Economic Forum recently named mis- and disinformation one of the short-term global risks, research has repeatedly shown that only a minority of people actually believes in it, and usually that's information that is already in line with what they believe in. This is why in populist and polarized contexts, misinformation is especially successful when trust in democracy and institutions is low. Although emotions can be very helpful signals, we know very little about their function in the context of misinformation. We can't even say if they make us fall for misinformation or if they help us recognize it better. So in essence, I study if misinformation makes people more emotional, which then leads to higher engagement on social media. Social media platforms already use AI in their algorithms to recommend content to us, and everybody who uses TikTok knows that it works pretty well. But social media platforms also like to gatekeep information on how those algorithms work, which makes it hard for researchers to understand if it's the algorithms or bad human behavior that we reproduce and intensify on social media. But with major advances in generative AI, for instance, the release of ChatGPT, there are wide debates whether the internet will soon be flooded by misinformation. Misinformation, AI generated or not, is already pretty persuasive and still only few people believe in it. The bottleneck here is not the quantity or the quality of misinformation, it is whether it can grab people's attention in this very competitive information environment that we live in. People don't just fall for misinformation just because it's believable, but because it benefits them in some way or it fits what they already believe. I use large amounts of social media data to study misinformation and emotions where it actually happens. But studying social media data is pretty complicated because we can't really distinguish individual from collective behavior and the algorithmic design of social media platforms. Here, misinformation serves as a tool rather than being the cause, in that it has more degrees of freedom to speak to its perfect audience on social media. I hope that our research contributes to isolating the causes and effects of misinformation such that it informs policies and makes citizens rebuild trust in democracy. I chose the University of Vienna because of the Computational Communication Science Lab and the Complexity Science Hub in Vienna. I think that this type of interdisciplinary work between social scientists and computer scientists can help us study things where they happen and advance techno-social questions.